wet processing of textile material. So today we will be learning about various techniques and procedures that have been followed for wet processing. Now let us learn what is wet processing. As the name suggests, wet processing is a process which is undertaken which is in wet medium, wherein we use moisture or water. So the main ingredient for the process is the substrate or the material, which we known as textile material. Other than that, we use chemicals and auxiliaries and water. The procedure which starts from wet processing of cotton is singeing. So let us learn what is singeing. The process of singeing is removal of fibers from the surface of the material. The material can be yarn or the fabric. The yarn singeing might be dangerous as it can rupture the yarn or deteriorate the strength of the yarn. So most of the textile processors go with fabric processing. In fabric processing, there are three different methods which have been followed. The first being the gas singeing method, the second being the rotary singeing method, and the third one being the hot plate method. In hot plate method, the material is being processed or passed at a very high speed over heated glass plates. So on these plates, the material is passed wherein the material is being singed from its protruding fibers. So what are protruding fibers? So protruding fibers are these tiny little fibers which are not bound inside the yarn and which stand out on the fabric. So these materials or these tiny fibers form fuzz. We call them as fuzz, and they stand on the material top. So this has to be removed. Being the second method is gas singeing method. In gas singeing method, the material is passed over the gas flame and the material is passed at very, very high speed so as to avoid burning of the fabric itself. So the gas singeing method removes all fiber tops from the surface of the material. The third method being the rotary singeing method, wherein two hot plate rollers are rolling at simultaneous speeds, and then in between this a fabric material is being passed at very high speed. Here once again the material is taken off from its the fuzz is taken off from its surface. So let us see the material, how it is and what is the structure. First, when we have our material, we call it as raw material. So these materials have these protruding fibers. So these fibers are protruding out of the surface of the material. Hence, when the incident light I is being incident on the material, it does not reflect back in an even pattern, which is R. So since it is not in an even pattern, the light gets distracted. So when the light is distracted, the material is not shiny and the shine or the luster of the material is lost. Hence the material looks more dull. So after singeing, the material becomes very soft, smooth, and the surface is clear. So when we have an even surface, so the incident light I is reflected back in a very even pattern, leading to an even pattern of reflection which gives more shine or luster. Hence the material become more lustrous. So this is very helpful when we go for printing and for material which is being used in high-end garment making. So the material looks more shinier and the color which is being dyed will look more brighter. Hence for increasing the brightness and also to make the surface more smoother, we do singeing. So the first process of singeing, wherein we learn gas singeing method, the material is being passed over the gas flames. So when the material is passed over the gas flames at very high speed, due to the flame and the heat of the flame, the protruding fibers on the material is being burnt away. So this process is known as gassing off, because we use gassing method or we use gas flames to remove the protruding fibers from the fabric surface. So once this is removed, the material becomes more even and more lustrous. Later this has been brushed away and the fibers which are burnt are been removed away. So this could be done in fabric stage or as well as in the material, that is yarn stage. The method 2 is your roller singeing method, wherein we use rollers. So these are huge rollers which will be heated up from the inside. So there is a gas supply and there is a burning facility which heats up the roller from the outer surface. So the circumference of the surface or the circle is completely heated up. So what happens when the material passes between these two rollers is both the surface of the material is being singed evenly. This is happening at high speed of around 100 meters per minute. So what happens during this stage is the protruding fibers are being completely burnt off without a fear of being material burnt. So this is much more safer when compared to the earlier method of gas singeing or gassing. Now we have the third method of singeing. In this method, we use hot plates. Now what are these hot plates? There is a curvature of the plate which has been bent over the heating flames. So these flames are not directly in touch of the material, just like what we did with our gas singeing method. So the material does not come in direct touch or in contact with the material, that is the textile material. But there is one flaw in this method is that the material is not singed on both the sides. Whereas in roller singeing method, since we have two rollers and the material passes between the roller, both the sides of the material is being singed evenly and simultaneously. So hence it is less time consumption. Whereas here, it is only one side of the material which has been singed at one time. So it has to go to and fro to be singed on either sides. So here we have heating facility beneath the plate and the plate gets heated up and the material passes over the plate wherein the material is subjected to singeing and the protruding fuzz or the fibers are being burnt away completely. This method is much safer but not that effective when compared to roller singeing method or gas singeing method. Raw textile material is known as grey fabric or grey material. So what is this grey material? These materials are not processed. They are directly from the mills. So they have not undergone any kind of treatments, pre-treatments or any kind of finishes. Hence these materials are hydrophobic in nature. Hydrophobic is phobia or the fear of water. So they're not absorbent. We can say it as they do not absorb any moisture. So as the name suggests, wet processing, it is very important for textile materials to absorb moisture or water for further treatments like dyeing and printing. So it's very important for us to convert the hydrophobic material into hydrophilic material. Hydrophilic is one which absorbs moisture readily, which has liking or love towards the water. So what is hydrophobic material and how does the surface react? So if this is considered to be the fabric surface, so the fabric surface before being pre-treated or being preparatory processed into the preparatory section, the water molecule is not being absorbed. So it takes a lot of time to be absorbed. So the wetting is not even or wetting is not certain. So this material is sent into pre-treatment processes wherein the material loses its hydrophobic layer and becomes water absorbent. So it becomes hydrophilic in nature, wherein the water molecule is readily absorbed by the material and the surface of the material as well as the inner fibers of the material take in the water and becomes wet. So this medium is very important in wet processing of textile material, especially dyeing, printing and finishing. So here we begin with the primary process or the preparatory process of cotton, wherein the material is converted from hydrophobic to hydrophilic, the first process being desizing. So what is desizing? What does the name suggest? So D is removal of size, desizing. So what is size and why do we add this size? Size is a material which makes a protective covering over the yarns. So these are being applied during the weaving stage to facilitate weaving. During the weaving, the warp and the weft, that is the horizontal and the vertical yarns, go in rupture or they go one on other when they are being woven together. So this generates heat and friction. So due to this friction, heat is generated and due to the heat, there is a chance of yarn breakage. To avoid this yarn breakage, we have a protective covering or a layer over the warp yarns. Warp yarns are those which run parallel to the selvage. So these yarns are being sized. So there are various types of sizing agents which are being used like CMC, which is carboxymethyl cellulose, PVA, which is polyvinyl alcohol, liquefied starch, mutton tallow, pig fat, or rice starch. So something like this, which is either natural or it is which is made from man-made sources, are being used as starch. So these materials are being given a coat over the yarns before weaving. So once this process is finished, they start weaving. And after weaving, this material or the starch or the size is unwanted over the material because it forms a hydrophobic layer over the material. So this has to be removed, and the process is known as desizing. Desizing is removal of starch or size material from the surface of the yarn. Usually 8 to 10% of the material weight or the gray material weight is starch. So this has to be completely removed as much as possible so that the material becomes more absorbent. Other than this, we have impurities which are naturally derived, like we have the oils of the plant, vegetable oils or fats, or we have pectins or pigmentations, colorations, the external surface dust, etc. So all these together, when combined with starch, form a hydrophobic layer. So this layer has been removed, and to much extent, desizing helps in making the material more absorbent and water-liking or hydrophilic in nature. The objective of removing this starch is to make the fabric more wettable, readily absorbent, that it absorbs the moisture very easily, it becomes evenly wet, and then the later processes becomes very easy for the processor. Hence, the time consumed is less, the chemicals consumed is less, as well as the energy taken into processing also becomes less. So in other ways, we can put it like this: the entire process becomes more efficient and more effective when we have the material which is desized. And this also helps in even dyeing and printing. Hence, there will be no patchy dyeing, which will lead to rejection of the material. Once the material is desized, it is free from all added materials like starch. So the material which is hindering the absorbency is removed to partial extent, because the complete material which is making the cotton fabric more hydrophobic is not removed, because we have fatty acid, waxes, natural oils, etc. Now, how do we remove all these things? The next process is known as scouring. So the process of scouring removes various types of impurities which is naturally present and also added to the material. So what are these impurities? So as I mentioned earlier, so these impurities are fats, oils, waxes, vegetable oil, and other material which is driven from the nature. So these material which are hindering the material surface, that is the cotton material surface, has to be removed. So what do we do in scouring? So we process it with NaOH, which is sodium hydroxide solution, in certain temperature and time duration, wherein all these impurities are removed to an extent. So we expect around 4 to 5% of weight loss, that is the base material waste loss is around 4 to 5%. So about 4 to 5% of the material weight is lost. So all these percentage of weight loss is nothing but the impurities present in it. So let us see how it is being done. So we have fatty acids, vegetable oils and waxes present in the material. So this is processed with sodium hydroxide solution, which is NaOH. Under the presence of heat, when the material is boiled, it loses all its impurities and breaks down. That is, the fatty acids breaks down and glycerin also is formed. Now the glycerin is water soluble. So the nature of glycerin is water soluble. So glycerin gets mixed into the water and it is solubilized, whereas the fatty acid still remains in the material in a broken condition. Further to it, soap has been added along with NaOH. So this process enables the material to get away from all the impurities. So the fatty acid is further broken into small molecules which are solubilized into water, and these are emulsified in the presence of soap. So there is a thin layer of emulsification or the emulsion which has been formed, and this has been removed. The first process wherein the soap is formed is known as saponification, and the second process is known as emulsification. So in emulsification, all the dirt is already on the surface of the water bath. So this is being skimmed away like the cream from the milk. So after this, the material becomes completely free from oils, fatty acids and vegetable oil contents. So all these are been removed, making the fabric more absorbent and readily absorbing the dye molecules, which is very important in textile wet processing. Next comes bleaching process. Now, why do we bleach the material? If at all the cotton material has to be dyed in darker shades, we need not bleach the material. The natural color will be hidden because of the high shade of the dye. But if the material has to be dyed in pastel colors or light colors like cream, orange, pista green, lemon yellow, etc. So the material has to be bleached so that it looks more bright. So the natural material which has been already singed, desized and scoured still has impurity, which is known as the natural color. Natural cotton is available in different shades like cream, yellow or to brown. So these colors has to be removed before dyeing, especially when dyeing with lighter shades. So the process of removal of these colors are known as bleaching. The process of bleaching involves H2O2, which is known as hydrogen peroxide. The extra molecule of the hydrogen peroxide reacts with the material in the presence of sodium silicate, which is a stabilizing agent, and the color which is present there naturally has been removed. So this makes the material more whiter. So when the material becomes more white, it becomes easy for the dyeing agent or the dyeing person to bring in light shades in a very bright way. Other than this, we use OBAs. OBA is optically brightening agent. Like we use an optical brightener to make the material look more bright and white. So this again helps when the material is being dyed in light shades. Further to the processing of cotton, we have a process known as mercerization, which was found by John Mercer in 1844. So in mercerization, four T's are very important: time, temperature, twaddle and tension. Twaddle is the concentration of NaOH solution, that is sodium hydroxide solution, which is being used. Tension becomes very important so that the material swells evenly and there is no irregularities in the material swelling. Time and temperature is a variable. Depending on both or one, the temperature can be varied or the time can be varied. This has to be done under surveillance of an experienced person so that the material is not being damaged. Now coming to mercerization, the process begins with the interior walls of the cell. So the cross section of a cotton is kidney bean shaped. So when this kidney bean shaped cell is hit by an incident light I, and due to the irregularity of its shape, the reflectant light R is scattered. So when the light is scattered, it does not give a lustrous surface. So the shine or the sheen of the material has been lost. So during mercerization, we make sure that the material swells permanently. And due to this swelling, the kidney bean shape of the cotton fiber is lost and we get a semicircular or almost a circular shape which reflects back the incident light into an even pattern R. So this makes the material more lustrous or shinier. So when we go for light colored shades, the material becomes more bright and it reflects back the light very evenly. So this leads to very even finished and well finished material. So the cotton material undergoes various processes before dyeing and printing. So these processes are known as wet processing or preparatory processing. So these preparatory processes goes in a flow, which is singeing, removal of fuzz or protruding fibers from the material surface. Later we have desizing, removal of size which has been added during weaving to make the material more water absorbent. Later we have scouring of the material, wherein we remove all the natural and added impurities from the material surface, making it more readily absorbent. We have bleaching, wherein we remove the natural color present in the material, especially during dyeing, which has been done in lighter shades. And we have mercerization, wherein the kidney bean shape of the cotton material is converted into a circular shape or a rounded shape due to the presence of NaOH, tension, temperature. So the material becomes more reflectant. Lastly, we have OBA, which is optical brightening agent, which helps in increasing the lustre and the optical brightness of the material. This is very, very important in preparatory processes because it makes material ready for dyeing and printing. Hence, The preparatory process is a major process which is there in cotton, silk or wool processing. Thereby, with today's class, I conclude the preparatory processes of cotton. Thank you.